Data used within a GIS can be grouped into vector and raster types. Vector data can be stored as points, lines, or polygons. In contrast, raster data are cell or pixel based. On this map, two examples of vector point features are shown, springs and airport locations. The springs here are symbolized in blue, and the airports are symbolized as an airplane. Point features are coordinates with associated aspatial or tabulated information. For example, the attribute table for the springs layer provides a variety of information about each spring. The major interstates in the state are represented here as yellow lines and are an example of line vector data. Line features have length, but no width. The county boundaries are stored here as vector polygon features. Polygons are aerial features. The attribute table for this layer stores information about each county. I will now turn off the vector layers so that we can see the raster features. First, we have a continuous raster grid that represents elevation in meters across the state. This layer is called a digital elevation model, or DEM. In this raster grid, each cell holds an integer elevation measurement. By clicking on a cell, we can see the elevation measurement stored in that cell. Using the layer properties, we can see that this is a 16-bit raster grid, which means that 2 to the 16th power number of unique integer values are available. The next raster layer represents land cover for the entire state from the National Land Cover Database. In contrast to the elevation raster, this raster layer would be described as a categorical raster. Clicking on a cell, we can see that each cell still holds a number. However, now the number is a stand-in for a category, in this case the type of land cover at that location. Lastly, we have image data. Image data are also a type of raster data. For image data, each cell is called a pixel. Unlike the raster data already discussed, image data are actually made up of a stack of multiple grids. For a true color image, such as this image, there are red, green, and blue grids that are combined to produce a color at each cell. By navigating to this image file in the directory, we can see that it is composed of three separate raster grids, or bands, representing the red, green, and blue channels. However, the software is able to combine these three bands to create a true color image. Lastly, all raster images have a defined cell size that is provided in the layer properties. For example, the cell size of the land cover raster is 30 by 30 meters, or 900 square meters. We can also measure the cell size using the measuring tool. Using the measuring tool, we can see that each pixel measures 30 meters in each dimension.